H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
All right, so we'll begin with the session. Meanwhile, whoever joins, they can continue from there itself. So a very good evening. We are having today is a demo class for Selenium. Okay, so as part, let me first introduce myself, then I can we can have a small round of introduction of each one of you. But there are not many participants, so we'll see how we can introduce each one of you. I'm Sonal Mittal.
Hi, Sonal. Can you hear me?
Yeah,
this I can hear you. Yeah, this is Harita.
Harita, okay. Hi, Harita. Yeah.
Thank you.
So my background, as in I've been working with an MNC for the last 12 years, okay? And I've been into various domains, like telecom, banking, and finance, as well as I have started my career as a manual tester long time back. Moved into the roles of QA lead and then as a project manager. Meanwhile, when I before as I moved into the lead positions as manager position, I did not enjoy project management much of it. So the next option I thought was going into automation testing. That's when I discovered my interest and my passion for tools, automation software tools. So I have earlier during those days, QTP and load runner were most commonly used tools. So I'm a certified load runner, quality center, and QTP tester. So then moved on later, came open source tools, and then I worked on Selenium for some time. So I've been training in Selenium for last 5 years, as well as I train its extension tools like APM, mobile automation testing. Yeah, so I have been working with the H2K Infosys for providing training on automation tools. And so today's demo class will be on Selenium. We'll have a brief introduction. So we'll see a brief introduction on automation testing, okay, based on your background knowledge. We'll move ahead and I'll introduce basics on Selenium also today. Okay. Then we'll take QA sessions. We'll have a QA session, small QA session, where I can answer all your queries about the course, timings, and what all your expectations are from this course. Okay, that we can do. So that was about me, and what I'm going to focus today in the class. So meanwhile, I want to know there are too many participants. I think the one I have noted down are only. Think I've noted down only 12, and I'm sure there are more than that in the class. I want to know your background, as in, so all of you are from testing background, and how much knowledge are you having about automation tool? Randomly, anyone can speak up.
Hi, this is Sindhu. Hi, Sonal.
Yes, Sindhu.
Yeah, I'm originally from an accounting background, but I just finished my course with H2K Infosys, like with UFT and load runner and everything. And I'm still like due on doing a project, and I thought I'll also check out Selenium if that would help me.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. So at least you have a background knowledge about programming language and how do you script. All those details you have.
I mean, yeah. With you,
with load runner, you must be knowing.
Yeah.
You must be knowing.
And SQL, yeah.
Yeah, how about others? Archana, Kritika, Sharda, sorry. Can't hear you. Actually, your voice is too slow. I cannot hear you.
Okay. Can you hear me now?
Yeah, much better.
Okay, this is Harita. Actually, I worked as a mainframe developer for a couple of years, but then I got a gap. I got some gap in my career, so I'm restarting my career now. So I just thought like starting as a QA now. So I took QA and both QA and BA course I took from H2K, and I took database testing classes as well. And now I just thought like just knowing, getting to know more details about Selenium, if that would help my resume get some weightage for jobs. That's all.
Thanks, Arita.
Okay.
Hi, Sonal.
Sorry, couldn't hear you.
I'm Kritika. Even I just finished my QA training with H2K and did my UFT and load runner. And I just want to check on the demo class of the Selenium. So I would.
Right.
That's it about me.
Sure. Thanks.
Hi, Sonal.
Yeah. Hi.
This is Meeta, and my background is a medical, in a medical, and I just finished my QA course along with UFT. It's a basic UFT only, and now everybody says that you should know one automation tool. So I'm not sure whether I should go to with Selenium or UFT. That's it. Yeah.
All right. Yeah. This demo session should give an idea to each one of you as to what Selenium is, what's the life cycle of a Selenium test process, and how it's going to help you in your career. So I hope this demo will give you that that start ahead. So let's, if anyone else want to introduce or want to speak up, otherwise I would begin with today's demo session. All right, so we will begin with today's session. I have a small PPT that I have prepared. Actually, there are two, and I'm confused which one to show you guys. All right, so can you see my screen? Right? I think all of you are having a background about testing. All of you have got a QA. Background training, a QA training sometime back, and you have an some or the other introduction about automation testing also, right? So let's begin with that only, as to what is automation testing. Okay, so suppose let's say I have a scenario where I have to retrieve some bank account details, okay? Account details for 1,000 customers. Okay, there's a website, there's a web page, bank website, and in that I have details about every customer, whoever comes to that particular bank, who has an account in that bank. Okay, now I have that details over there, and as a tester I have to retrieve all the details and check few things in the in that particular detail. So I'm given that 1,000 customers in my bank who have the account. I have to retrieve the details and check whether the contact details are correct or not, their names are correct or not. So if I am a manual tester, how am I going to perform it? Any idea, anyone? If I am a manual tester. Sindhu. If you're a manual tester, what steps would you do? Can you guys hear me?
Yeah, I can hear
you. Yeah. So if you are a manual tester, what would you perform? What steps would you perform? Or how will you test? Let me put it this way. How will you test? Anyone?
Hi, Sonal. Hello.
Yeah. I can hear you. Who's this?
This is Anjali.
Yeah, Anjali.
I'm not sure. Maybe we can use the database like SQL to retrieve the details of the customers.
So you don't have the background access. Let's say you're just a manual tester. You're doing only a black box testing, okay? Where you are having a web page and you have to test all the customer details on that particular web page. Okay. Which is good that you can do a SQL query. Yeah. Or should I say fetch? Or anything, retrieve or fetch bank details, or rather, let me put it as test bank account details for 1,000 customers. So which is good, we can always have an SQL query and we can fetch all of those queries. But in case in that, if you have to check particular details, check if contact details are correct, right? Some particular details you have to check. So let's say if I am a manual tester, I would take 5 to 6 contacts, okay, run a SQL query, or I'll go to the web page, retrieve all these 5 contact details, okay, and check all those. Check whether I would check the names are correct or not. I would check if contact details are correct or not, right? And other requirements whichever have been mentioned in my test plan, I would do that, right? As a manual tester, I can do for 5 to 6 or maximum 10 or 15. If I have enough of time for testing, let's say my testing is for 3 months, three weeks, I could fetch other customers and test it. But that's not the only scenario which I have to test in my entire period of testing, okay, system testing or integration testing, right? So maybe, you know, what manual testers do is take middle value or in the boundary value analysis they would do. Start values or last values, you know, 100 to first 10 values, then 500 to 510 values, then 1,000. The last 10 values, they would pick up those contacts, check their names and details, and say that, yeah, the test case is passed or all the details are being retrieved correctly. Maybe I would do that, right? Mm-hmm. But if I had an automation tool, if I had an automation tool, I can easily test all the 1,000 customers at one go, right? Automation. If I was an automation tester, I would write a script, right? That would fetch all the contact details, all the 1,000 customers details, and verify the contact details and other details, whatever is mentioned in the requirements. So that would do only in few hours. I'll be able to write my script. I will be able to fetch all my 1,000 customers, not 100,000 customers, and verify the contact details. I would even easily get the output correct. And then I can pass or fail my test case based on that. That's what is the beauty of automation testing, right? I'm not telling manual testing has to be removed, but automation testing makes our task easy. So let's come here with a definition. See here. So test automation is use of special software to control execution of tests and comparison of actual outcomes with predicted outcomes. In simple terms, it makes the manual test procedure to be executed automatically. This is what we have done as part of this example also. A manual test case, we could easily, using a software tool, or we could create a script and perform that particular test case within very less time, right? What is the next slide? The next slide is about why we have to do automation. Before moving on to Selenium, LoadRunner, UFD, we need to know why we have to perform automation, right? just like that, since we are provided an effort for automation in our testing schedule, we do not need that. I mean, it's not necessary that we have to go for an automation. I have an example for you here. Okay, let's say we are testing a web page, okay, and you are the tester for that. You log in into that web page at around let's say 7 p.m. You logged in. Your web page was successful. Okay, and then you were successfully able to log into the particular website. Okay, you're able to successfully able to log. Then again, around 8 o'clock, when you log in, your login was not successful. Okay, it gave some error that web page not found. It's under development. Okay, your web page is under development. So, and you are testing it. It has come to the QA phase. So when you are testing, it says some for around at around 7 o'clock it was successful. At 8 p.m. it was unsuccessful. Login. Unsuccessful. You get some error on the web page. Okay, so you report it to the dev team saying that I'm unable to log into the web page. And again, around 12 a.m., let's say, when you log in, you was able to log in successfully. The web page opens correctly. Okay, so what do you call this? Website now? Is it a stable web page or unstable web page? Anyone?
Unstable.
It's unstable.
Right. So this is unstable web page. Sometimes it's opening, sometimes it's not. So in such cases, we should not go for automation. I would not go for an automate. If I create my script on this particular web page, sometimes it will execute, sometimes it may fail. It might not even log in the web page. Leave aside executing some test steps in that. So the effort I have spent on creating a script goes waste, right? So we will have to make sure when we start automation, our application, whichever is under test, should be stable. Only then we should go ahead with testing, right? So do not just since the automation is in demand now, we should start automating. That's not the criteria. We should make sure first manual testing has to be completed. The application has to be stable. Only then we should begin our automation testing, right? So why we have to automate? There are a few things. Manual testing and test automation have divided the slide into two parts. Okay. When the manual testing is time consuming, we have seen that, right? We have to fetch huge amount of data, and that too, it is repetitive. Repetitively, we have to fetch the data. After few weeks, again, we have to fetch the same 1,000 customers. After 3 weeks, again, we have to fetch. It's time consuming. I would surely go for automation. It's less reliable. I understand that as we would be testing all the cases, whichever are based on the requirement, we would be doing the test cases, we'll be executing all the test cases. But still, there are chances that we may leave some test cases because the time was not sufficient or tester was not available, right? So it's less reliable when compared to an automation test. There is high risk of human error. You all would be knowing that. There's a huge risk of human error. There are chances that we may miss. We can understand that with the same example. Let's say if I'm doing a manual testing where I have to test details for 1,000 customers, right? Then as a manual tester, I'm just checking only maybe 100 customer details.
Oh,
the rest, nothing. Sorry? Yeah. Rest 900, I would have not tested those. So there are chances that some error must be there in some other account details, right? So it is a high risk of human error. Now, so let's come to this test automation. What does it provide? Why test automation? Speed, right? It will be very fast. So we have to do why test automation, sorry, because of the speed. We can easily finish our testing in no time. We can easily finish our testing in no time, right? And reliable. It's quite reliable, high reliability, because I just got distracted. It's highly reliable because it's the script which is executing our test cases, and whatever you would have recorded, each and every step will be executed, right? So it's highly reliable. Then coverage, all the test cases will be covered as part of test automation. As a manual tester, based on the time or effort, we might miss few test cases, but when we are doing automation, we would cover all the test cases. So it gives 100% coverage, 100% reliable, and very fast. Repeatability. Any test cases which has to be repeated, like regression test cases which have to be executed after every new build, or verifying the test cases after the defect fixes, that can be done using automation. Saves lots of effort. Reusability. Same test case can be executed again and again. You can reuse them, right? Yeah. So that was about why we have to do test automation. The last point here is that make sure that the testing procedures are systematic. Consistent and 100% reproducible. Minimize the error-prone manual testing. Automation will reduce the manual testing effort and errors. Right. Let's come to the next slide, which is benefits of automation testing. Right. As I have told you here, we can easily see the benefits of automation testing. Right. We can easily complete on time. It will save a lot of our time. It will save a lot of effort. Right. It will reduce the errors. Right. It'll 100% coverage. The money spent on a manual testing and the amount spent on an automation testing is much less when you look at the project side. Right, what else are there? Yeah, lower total cost of ownership, better quality, okay, consistency and standard procedure. Right, you will not deviate from the process or from the testing process. Sometimes you are testing boundary value, sometimes you are testing starting value or and the end value, like that. Right, you would not deviate from that when we are doing automation testing. We would follow a standard process. Increased productivity. Your productivity will also increase. Within less time, you will be able to execute more number of test cases. Those are the benefits of automation. Now, yeah. So I had this. I just wanted to discuss this introduction about automation testing to you. Now I want to move on to Selenium. Any doubts? Any? Yeah.
Excuse me. You said it lowers the cost, right? How come it like we need to pay more money for automation tools and everything, right? When you said the advantages in the,
right. You will just spend once for the buying the tool. That's all. But the number of testers will be only one or two automation testers. But if you have to spend on manual testing, maybe the team might need 5 to 6 testers. If it is 5 to 6 testers, maybe you know. How much I have to pay? Let's say I pay some $40,000. Not that's too less. $60,000 to $70,000 per year for one tester, right? The amount I'm going to pay is more, right? For testers, and then when I have to buy only one tool, I just have to buy one license. Let's say license tool for if it is load runner or QTP, I'll buy the license tool and I'll need only one or two testers to perform the testing. It'll reduce my effort. Total cost of ownership, right? Yeah, that way. Of course, the amount of you will need some time for manual testing also, as well as for automation testing.
Right? Okay. So, okay. Thank you.
Yeah. Another thing which comes into picture here, of course, that's one good point you brought up, that we'll have to buy the tools. Yes, that's what my next slide also talks about. Load runner, QDP, UFT that we have now, or RPT, we all have to buy in such tools. We have to buy the license, right? You'll have to pay for the license. And if you buy the license, only one license or two licenses, only two or three testers can work on it, right? So that's again time consuming, and it is not cost effective. In such cases, we have Selenium as our tool. It's an open source tool. It's free of cost. It's easily available on the web. Anyone can download this tool and work on it. Okay. We don't need any license. So if you're a team of 5 testers, you can easily download the Selenium tool, okay, from web and start automation. This tool is used for functional testing, okay, like how we have QDP, but the only drawback is it is used for web pages to test or to do functional testing for web pages. We cannot do automation testing for desktop applications using Selenium. But it's highly in demand, and most of the companies nowadays are scrapping up manual testing and they're moving into automation testing, and Selenium is a tool which is being used for functional automation testing, because not all the companies would want to invest in buying license for LoadRunner or UFT, right? So they see this is one of the easy way to start with automation testing. That's what my next slide also is. Tell me.
I had to log off because I had a issue with audio. Can you repeat that point of like open source tool?
I'm just repeating. If you look at my slide, everyone, Selenium is a portable software testing framework for web applications. In 2004, Selenium was first introduced in 2004. Let me come here. Selenium first introduced in 2004 by Jason R. Higgins, and its first name was JavaScript Functional Tester, JSFT. Used in 2004 and was earlier called as JSFT. JSFT is JavaScript Functional Tester. Okay. Yes. Selenium is an open source tool. What I mean by open source tool is it's easily available on web. Any tester can download it from the web and start with their functional testing. You do not have to buy the license to start functional testing. Okay. It's an open source tool. It is a free tool. Free. It's easily available online. You can easily download the Selenium tool. Okay. And start working on it. Okay. All Selenium projects were released under Apache 2 license. Selenium projects were released under Apache 2.0 license. Okay. And second thing is, it's free of cost, as I told you. Anyone can download and use all the Selenium projects with free of cost. Anybody can modify the source code and distribute the source code, but you cannot edit it. You cannot sell it, rather. You cannot sell it. What I mean here is anyone can download. If you are a team of 5 testers, all 5 of you can download Selenium from web. It's free of cost. Okay. Now using this, every code, if you see, every tool will have a source code. Okay. In Selenium, it gives us an advantage to modify the source code. We are the learners. We have just started learning Selenium. You will not be able to modify the source code as of now, but maybe around the line, maybe after 3 years or maybe after a year, you're so good in Selenium that you want to change the features of Selenium tool. You can always send the new features or new additions you want to add to the Selenium team online, and they would add it in their next release if they feel it is good to add, or if they can adapt the change. Okay, so that by that anybody can modify the source code, and you can even distribute in the sense, if you are having in your machine, you can easily send that file to your other tester team member. If they don't want to download it from the web, you can always distribute it, give it back to them, give it to somebody. But you cannot sell it, okay? It's an open source tool. It's under the license version. You cannot sell it. That's what I mean. Okay. Now, Let's come back to the slide here. If you see here, Selenium, we also call it as Selenium WebDriver because it is one of the part of Selenium. There are four components of Selenium that I'll be showing you. Components of Selenium. Selenium is divided into four components. Selenium IDE. Okay, it's an integrated development environment. It's a play and record and play tool. It's a small tool. Okay, in Selenium. It can be used on a Firefox browser only. Okay, it's a record and play tool. It is an add-on on a Firefox browser. So the limitation here is it is to be used only on Firefox browser. You can easily record. I hope people who have an idea about load runner and UFP, you know, you can record your test steps and play the tool. Okay, play the test steps again. You can modify your input and then again play the recorded script and record the, once you have recorded the script, you can play it again and again by changing the input values, right? So in Selenium also, it has a separate tool. It's a separate component which comes with Selenium. It's called IDE, Integrated Development Environment. Okay, which is a add-on tool for Firefox browser. You can use it only on Firefox browser. You cannot use it on any other browser. That's a small limitation about IDE. When we begin the course, we will be discussing in detail on how to use the Selenium IDE, how we can record our script, how we can play our script, what are the different functions and methods in Selenium IDE. That's one of the component of Selenium. Another component.
I have a doubt. So we can't use this tool on the Google Chrome or any other browser?
No.
Is that okay? I didn't get it actually. Like it's a only, it works on Firefox browser, because I once, like last year, once I downloaded Selenium and I tried some small applications. Mm-hmm. But we can like use some Google Chrome and for example, if I'm testing an application, Amazon application, we can just remember trying like with different testing an application in different browsers.
I'm not telling that you cannot test in different browsers. You can test using Selenium in different browsers, but using IDE you can test only in Firefox browser. I'm sure you would have tested that Amazon on Firefox browser, because IDE is an add-on for Firefox browser only. You cannot add it on Chrome browser.
Is that IDE? So is Selenium and Selenium IDE both are different?
Yeah. What I'm talking here are components of Selenium.
Got it. Sorry, thank you.
There are four components in Selenium. Okay, let's do it this way. There are four components in Selenium. The first one is IDE, which is only for Firefox browser. Right. Coming to Selenium RC. Okay, so this was used earlier. It's not there now, it's outdated. We don't use it. This component is not used. We don't use it now, it's outdated. Not used. Okay, before that, okay, once let me not introduce this first to you. I want to introduce about Selenium WebDriver. Okay, Selenium WebDriver. So this is the second component of Selenium. This is where the actual functional testing, automation functional testing for any web page or for any application will be done. So WebDriver, Selenium WebDriver is that component of Selenium which is used for scripting, where you can create your scripts, where you can create your test cases for automation. Okay, and record your create the scripts and execute your test cases. So it's in Selenium WebDriver, that's where we create our automation test cases, execute those test cases and perform our automation testing. That's what is done in Selenium WebDriver. Here we can do synchronization, parameterization, verification, validation, you know, we can give different values, all those things, enhancing your test scripts. Everything is done in WebDriver. Okay, everything is done in WebDriver. I'll talk more about it in some time. Earlier, Selenium WebDriver, I think it has come into picture in 2007. The first version had Selenium ID and Selenium RC. So Selenium RC also means it was a recording, it was also used for creating automation test cases, but now it's outdated. An advanced version of that is WebDriver. But still we have this component in Selenium, the reason being to maintain projects which have been created earlier. Before 2007, there were some projects which were created using RC, right? There were scripts who were created using RC. So in order to maintain those projects, we have Selenium still has Selenium RC in its component list. Not used anymore for scripting. It's available only for maintaining existing projects. Okay, right. I hope you understand this point. It is needed because there were projects which were created earlier to 2007. So those cannot be converted in a WebDriver. Those have to be maintained using Selenium RC. Right, that's why we have this component in Selenium. The fourth and last component is Selenium Grid. Right, Selenium Grid, the concept here is, before that you have to look here. Let's look here. Somebody has just asked that you have done testing in other browsers. So this is an advantage of Selenium, where we can perform cross-browser testing. We can perform create a script or record a script. Okay, we can have a script and execute that script in all the browsers, Firefox, Chrome, IE, Opera, Safari, etc. In all the browsers, we can perform our testing, right? Parallel testing. Another thing which we can do is using Selenium is parallel testing. You on multiple browsers at the same time, you can perform. On multiple browsers, you can perform at the same time. So Grid is that part of the functionality. Using this component of Selenium, Selenium Grid, we can perform same test case, I would say like that, on different browsers at the same time. So in order to perform parallel testing, okay, on different browsers at the same time, we can perform it using Grid. Can we do this using other tools like LoadRunner and UFT? People who have got training on LoadRunner and UFT, can you tell me? Can we do that? Can you execute your test case in different browsers? LoadRunner is basically for desktop applications.
I just took a basic UFT classes. As far as I know, I don't think so. We can do it on different browsers at the same time.
Right, we cannot do that. It doesn't support UFT or LoadRunner. Basically, LoadRunner is for performance testing. It does not support multiple browsers or different browsers testing. That's the advantage of Selenium, and that is why everyone is now moving into Selenium and its components. Right, they are moving, they are learning. Everyone is learning Selenium and they want to go ahead and start their career as an automation tester with Selenium. And many companies are also opting for Selenium. One reason being it's free of cost, it's easily available. Second reason being you can easily perform your testing in all the browsers. It gives a complete for your testing, will be complete after it has been done using Selenium. Right? It's complete view to it. Right? You'll be able to test in all the browsers. You can test them parallelly also. Okay, and at the same time using Selenium Grid.
So, hello, Sonal.
Yeah.
I have a question. Which component is mainly used?
WebDriver. Selenium WebDriver.
And for the grid one, you can use just for the parallel testing?
Yeah, it's all execution. Okay. Let's when we actually go in the course, we can easily distinguish between the components. But for now, I can tell this is used for test planning. You create your test cases here, you enhance your scripts, you improve your test cases, you give input values to your test cases, and Grid we execute our can I say it this way? Right? So let's say this is outdated, we don't use RC. So WebDriver is where we do our test planning. We create our test cases, we write our scripts, we enhance our scripts, right? We run the scripts, debug the scripts, and we execute our test cases in different browsers in Selenium Grid. If you do not do planning or scripting in Grid, okay? Got it?
Sonal, that means when you are using WebDriver, you have to use the Grid, right?
No.
So then where can we execute all the test cases?
Yeah, in WebDriver itself, you can execute the test case. Yeah, okay, I get your point. Yes, after creating your scripts, yes, we use Grid. We go to the component called Grid and then execute our test cases over there. If you want to execute in different browsers at the same time, okay, if your prerequisite is execute a particular test case in all the browsers at the same time, then go to Grid. Okay. If you want to execute your particular test case only in one browser, let's say Chrome browser, then you can perform that in WebDriver only. Got it? In WebDriver, okay. I'll show you how we work in WebDriver. Let's see. This is Eclipse, and let's say we have a project here. Then we have different test cases here, like this. So these are different test cases that we have, and then we can execute each of these test cases. Run these test cases. We can execute these test cases, and our automation test cases can be executed. But if I have a particular test case, let's say this is a script, it's not for Selenium, it's some other tool script, but it's still Selenium is similar to this. I have a Selenium script also. Selenium, yeah.
So Sonal, do we have to write the scripts on Eclipse all the time?
Yeah. I'm coming to that part also.
Okay.
So if I have this, let's say Selenium script over here. Okay, if I where was I? Okay, and I want to execute in only in Chrome browser. Let's say I want to execute it only in Chrome. So I'll execute this script here. That's all. And my test case will be executed. It will go to that particular web page, google.com. I'll execute a few steps, whichever I have mentioned. My test steps will be executed. I can pass my test case. If I want to run it 1,000 times, I can run it 1,000 times also. But my test case is put it in Chrome, Firefox, IE, then I'll copy the script which was there, okay, in Grid, and choose my browsers and execute that test case. That we will detail, okay, that's all. These were the four components that I have in Selenium. We have to put this drive here. Sorry. Another tools which are supported by Selenium are language scripting languages, right? One plus point of Selenium is you can use multiple scripting languages like Java, C#, PHP, Ruby, Perl, Python. All these six languages can be used for scripting. Any one of these languages you can choose for your scripting. If you see UFT or load running, use C and DB+ for UFT, I think. I don't know the latest one. Earlier when I used it was DB+, right? So those are the languages that we use for scripting there. But in Selenium, you can script, you can create your scripts either using Java, if you know C#, you can use C#, sorry, PHP, if you know, you can use PHP, Ruby, Perl, Python. The most commonly used language, scripting language is Java, and then after that, Ruby. I have done scripting in Java as well as in Ruby. And the course will teach you scripting language using Java. I'll be teaching you scripting language using Java.
And if you want to use the Ruby, still we can use the Eclipse?
Yeah.
Okay.
Eclipse is just for the development environment, right? That's where you create this.
Okay, I thought Eclipse is only for Java.
No, I don't think so. Yeah. You can import or you can write.
Do we have to need all the Java knowledge for the Selenium?
Yeah, a basic core language is, knowledge is needed. Okay, I'll be teaching you anyways. Before I'll share the course details. Before I begin Selenium, the first foremost things we will spend some time on Java basics. I will be teaching you the Java basics and Hooks concepts, and only then I'll be moving to Selenium. Okay. Selenium supports.
Oh no, I have a quick question.
Multiple programming languages. Yeah.
So how long will your online course be? Yeah, would it be for 1 month, 2 months? How long are you teaching for? Sorry, can you repeat that? You have static.
It is for 5 weeks.
Sorry, you said 5 weeks?
The training will be for 5 weeks. Let me write down.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. Training will be for 5 weeks, which is 25 working days. It can extend to 20, another 2 to 3 days based on our learnings, based on our examples that we take, based on the project that we do, assignments that we do. So it may extend for two or three days. Otherwise, I generally wind it up in 25 working days. That's been 5 weeks. Okay.
Okay. And then what will the syllabus be?
I'll come to that.
Okay.
What then?
Nothing. Go ahead. Go ahead.
All right, thanks. So Selenium supports multiple programming language, scripting language.
Kunal?
Right? That is, yeah?
Yeah, can you go a little bit slowly? Java, your voice is cutting here, breaking down.
Yeah, just a second. Give me a moment, please.
Okay.
Is it better now? Can you hear me?
Yes, yes, yes. I can hear you. It's good now.
Yeah, thanks. Okay. We were talking about the scripting languages that we can use in Selenium, which is Java, Ruby, PHP, C Sharp, Perl, and Python. Right? Python is also commonly used scripting language. I have not worked on that, but yes, Java is the most commonly used. More than 70% of the testers, they use Java. The reason being, it's easily the help or the support which is available for Java is more online also, as well as within the software fraternity. We have many Java testers who know Java language when compared to PHP or Perl or Python. So that's another reason that we'll go with Java. So I'll be teaching Java core basic fundamentals of Java, Hooks concepts, and then I will begin with Selenium. So we'll spend a good amount of time on learning Java. People with non-programming background also, they'll be easily be able to learn Java. Initially, it will be tough. For 2-3 days, it'll be not so, you may not be comfortable, but then once we practice more and more number of examples, you will easily be able to learn Java. The next point is easy framework development. Selenium. The most important thing in Selenium is it helps. It supports frameworks like data-driven, keyword-driven, and hybrid frameworks. Whenever you go for any interview or in your career, they don't talk about what components you have in Selenium, what browser you have in Selenium. They talk about frameworks. The more number of, even on web, if you see, the interview questions are filled up with the types of frameworks, development frameworks that are used in Selenium. So we will learn all about it during our course, different types of frameworks. We'll also have TestNG and JUnit framework, which is used in Selenium. In any automation tool, it is used. So we'll learn all about that also as part of my Selenium training. Now, I'll show you the course details as to what all we are going to learn. Here it is. First, as I told you, we will be learning about Java because that's the base for our scripting. Okay, so I'll be spending around the first week and a half of the next week on learning about Java basics and fundamentals, where I'll teach you different concepts of Java. Then we will learn with examples. You will have a hands-on training on each of the every example that we practice, and all the material, all the programs, all the scripts, all the class notes, will be shared, and the recordings as well will be shared with you. Okay, you can easily access those and learn later also and use it for your guidance. Okay, then we are going to ahead and learn about Selenium. First, these are just the in detail we will learn about all the four components of Selenium, and then we will learn about different elements on a web page. Okay, we have different a web page is made up of web elements, right? We'll learn about all the elements and how we can use. There's a concept called locators. We'll learn about that, and then we will build generally I think the then we'll learn about ID. I don't take it nowadays. I don't take ID first because it's not commonly used. ID, since it's restricted only to Firefox, we don't use it, this feature of Selenium nowadays. We directly go and start working on WebDriver, right? Start working on Selenium WebDriver. After I finish about WebDriver, how we set, how we can set up the environment of Selenium WebDriver, how we can configure the WebDriver in Eclipse. After we finish that, we will start with the scripting using Java, okay? And once we finish all us on how we write the script, how we enhance the script, how we synchronize, how we can provide multiple inputs to the script, after we finish those concepts, we will go ahead and work on IDE. Then I will go on IDE. In WebDriver, after IDE and WebDriver, I would teach you about TestNG and JUnit assertions. Then I'll also be teaching about database connection with Selenium. If needed, I can provide it, otherwise it's not required. Then about grid, Selenium grid, and I'll also be, as an addition to that, I'll also teach you how to integrate a tool Jenkins with Selenium and use that. Okay, then towards the end we will have frameworks. We'll learn about different frameworks, different types of frameworks, use of frameworks, and what are the different types of packages in frameworks. We'll discuss in detail about it because it's very important. Okay, after every component I will be giving you an assignment which you will have to work on your own, and then we will discuss in the class. And if you see, after every class, when the class starts, we would do a recap of the previous class, then we will discuss that day's topic, then we will end the class and we will have a small quiz about the topics that we have discussed. Okay, we'll have a quiz on locators, we'll have a quiz on ID, we'll not have resume preparation. Yeah.
When these classes will start?
I cannot give you the date. I think H2K, the training team will contact you, will give you the date as to when the class is starting.
May I know the class timings?
Even that, I think it's going to be the same timing, 9 to 10 or maybe 8 to 9, any one of those timings.
Okay, thank you.
So this is a prerequisite. If you have to, you know, learn Selenium, you should have a basic knowledge on the testing frameworks and process. I think you all have a testing background. A knowledge on scripting language, even if you don't have it, it is all right, because the first foremost thing we are going to do is learn Java. Okay, so we'll learn the scripting language and a knowledge on different browsers. Of course, you all know about different browsers like Chrome, Firefox, and Safari. That's the most commonly used browsers. I'm sure you all have it. Yeah. So these are the increasing trends. Please go ahead.
I don't have knowledge on testing frameworks.
It's okay. Testing frameworks is test process and testing methodologies. Testing background. Okay. Are you from a testing background? Yeah. That's all. Even if you don't have, even if there is somebody, I have trained people who don't have any testing background. Selenium is the first automation tools. Selenium is the first automation testing or a QA course that which you have taken. It's all right. My course do have introduction to all the automation tools, introduction to your testing process and methodologies. One plus point which you will have is that I will be sharing the real-time examples with you when I'm teaching each and every topic. Okay, since I have worked, I am currently working as a Selenium tester also. Okay, so I will be sharing with you the real time challenges that we face, real time experiences with Selenium tool too. That's an addition to the course. Okay, so if you see the trend of the jobs have been.
If you don't mind, may I know how many years of experience do you have on Selenium?
I've been working in Selenium from 2008. Okay. That's when the new WebDriver was introduced. That's when I started working with Ruby, and later it was not very. I was not very successful in using Ruby with my web page. It was not. There were some issues which we were facing. Then we moved on in Java, and currently also I'm using Java as the scripting language. And been creating frameworks and been using the driver grid for my project. Yeah.
Okay, thank you.
And earlier we used to do Selenium, but since it was just introduced, it was like an add-on to your resume, add-on to your goals in the company, you know, where if you're learning an automation tool. Because the most commonly used automation tools were load runner, that's what we were using. QDP was one we were using. Then Selenium was introduced in the market, it was a great relief to all the testers. First, it being an open source tool and anybody can download. Second, it's very easy to use this tool. Nowadays, also you see many testers, they would use Selenium, this feature, IDE feature of that. You can easily record and play your test cases, right? At least you'll get a feel about the automation too. Yeah, but it's limited only to Firefox. But if you want to enhance your script, you want to add more test steps to your script, then we have to go with scripting, right? Even IDE will generate a script which you can use for automation. But WebDriver is a component where you can enhance your scripts as per your requirement, right?
Hello, Sonal.
Yeah.
Can you give a brief introduction of TestNG?
Okay. So TestNG is a framework that is used in Selenium. Okay. If you want to execute, let's come here. If you want to execute multiple test cases, okay, generally, let's say in the script, in testing scripts, what we do is, we can have multiple test cases within a single script. Okay, that is called as a test suite. Okay, we'll have test case one test case two and test case three. Okay, so if it is a prerequisite, okay, the test case one, let's say, is a prerequisite for test case. And this is test case three is a post condition to be executed after test case two. Okay, so my test case two is the main requirement to be executed. Okay, my main test case is to execute. Let's say I want to log in to Gmail. Okay. So my first prerequisite will be. First test case is open, let's library open Gmail page. Okay. Then I would log into Gmail page. And then last is log out. Perform some actions also, log into Gmail page, log into my mail, Gmail, and send an email, let's say. Okay. Post condition is log out. Right. So anytime I want to send an email, my prerequisite is I have to open my Gmail page, log into it, send an email and log out. So these are my prerequisites. If I'm using writing scripts, these are three scripts I will have. For an example, I have three scripts. In case you have a background about scripting or any automation tool, you will understand that I'll have three scripts for this. I can execute one after the other. But if I have to execute all the three scripts one after the other, I will use the concept of TestNG. Okay, so I'll execute this first step using some annotations in TestNG. This concept of TestNG. I'll first execute test case one, then execute test case two, then execute test. Executing test cases in a fashion so that my testing will be completed and all the prerequisites and post conditions will be executed. It's nothing but test NG or J unit, right? That's about test NG. So how we execute our scripts, that's the framework, test NG framework, right? Who was this? Who has this doubt?
Yeah, this is Anjali. I got it, Anjali. So, thank you.
So there are multiple annotations over here. There are multiple methods that we use in test NG. Annotation you will not understand now. Different ways that we use to execute our scripts. So this is one of it. Okay. We have other multiple ways that we use in order to execute test NG. So it's kind of framework. Yeah. Any more doubts, anyone?
Hi Sonal, when you said enhancing a script, I don't know what you meant by that.
So when we write a script, we'll write a basic script. Let's say I want to just log into a Gmail page and send an email. Okay, so I'll write my script for that. Script in the sense, I'll write my code.
Okay.
To log into a Gmail page and send an email to that. But let's say I want to log in for 10 customers. If I want to log in for 10 customers, then I have to enter that input value in my script, right? My script should run 10 times with 10 different customers, with 10 different user IDs, right? So that's called enhancing. How will I enhance my script? I will have a basic script to log into a web page. Okay. I'll enhance it.
Okay.
My script by adding steps, let's say, that will log into the web page 10 times, let's say, with different user IDs. That's one kind of, you know, enhancing. Then I can enhance my script by adding few verification points.
Okay.
By verification points, I mean, you know, I can have a point like whether the correct user ID and password has been logged in or not, whether if the wrong password has been entered, whether an error message is being displayed or not. So I can enhance my script by adding few verification points in that, right? We do it in our manual testing also. We do negative testing. We check for verification, whether the correct error message is displayed or not. Then we can also do synchronization, you know, you know, we add the sleep time within our scripts. If you have, if people who have background about a few tools, we have the sleep time.
Okay.
Like when a tool is executing some steps, okay, tool is step number two, but your web page is still not open. So my script will fail because there's a certain time, right? The script will take some 5 minutes to execute and the web page only is not opening, right? Your script will fail. So at that time, sometimes the testers give a sleep time to, you know, let's say some 3000 milliseconds. So your script will start executing after 3 seconds. So once the web page opens, then execute the script, something like that. You can give certain points. So this is called enhancing. In basic script, I will just have my test step to execute. How will I execute that particular functionality? But enhancing, some things that we do. We add multiple data. Then we add verification points using if and else statements that comes as part of Java. I'll teach you all that. Then we add, we do synchronization.
Okay.
In detail, we'll learn about it. So all those things we can add. What else can we add in?
So this is called data-driven testing.
Yes, this is called data-driven testing. Data-driven testing is, adding, passing multiple input to your script, either by an Excel or an XML file or directly in the script is called as data-driven testing. Yeah. We will cover even that also during our course.
Okay. So this is like an in-depth Selenium course, right?
Yes, it will be. But after this course, you can easily perform your testing. I'm not just going to teach you about record and play script. That's all. Mm-hmm. You're going to even be able to write the scripts. You will be able to enhance your scripts. You'll be able to run your scripts on different browsers. By end of this course, you'll have an enhanced knowledge about Selenium.
Okay. Cool. Yeah, thanks.
Hi, Sonal. My name is Pranita. I have a question. What tool is used exactly, like for UFT? We use the HP UFT tool, right? Mm-hmm. So for even for Selenium, is the Eclipse is the tool?
No.
Selenium is the tool itself only.
Yes, Selenium IDE is one of the tool. WebDriver is another tool. Eclipse is the environment where we'll write our scripts, but we'll have some jar files. Okay, I'll show you where then you can download Selenium. Hold on. So we have a web page. Okay, over here you have downloads, right? Mm-hmm. So if you see here, you have tool details about Selenium. You have Selenium client and web driver. So these are jar files which are available. We have to download this and put it in our Eclipse. We have to download and build the path in Eclipse for this. Okay, we have to put it in our Eclipse in our project. I'll show you how we do that. And then we'll write Java scripts here. Okay, we'll write scripts here. Execute those using web driver, using the Selenium web driver. Okay. Then you also have Selenium IDE tool, which you can use. Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay, somebody was asking for Chrome. Yeah, Selenium IDE is a Chrome and Firefox browser. You can use it in Chrome also. This is something latest. I have not used it in Chrome and Firefox plugin, which records and plays it. You can use it for Chrome also. There's a latest revised version, which has been introduced. Okay, you can download it for the Chrome also. Fine, it was a mistake from my end.
Since you told that it's mainly Java based, so will you give any brief idea about like how this tool is used for C# or Ruby or Python? No?
That will extend our course a lot. We will not spend so much of time.
Yeah, I mean just a kind of example or something will you be teaching in the course? Like how would...
If you want, I can show you. Mm-hmm. If you want, I can show you when we do IDE. I can easily show you how we can create a script in Java. We can create a script in C#, Ruby, Python, JavaScript. I can show you that. We can do that. I can spend some time on it, but not much. Not an issue.
Okay. Being a non-IT background, and then do we have to have basic knowledge of the core Java before the course starts,
you don't need it. Even if you don't have it, if you have it, it is good. If you don't have it, it's okay. Because I'm going to spend 1 week to 1.5 weeks on core Java. So if you are clear with basics, only then I will move on Selenium. Okay?
Because so that I will be the first. That it's a little bit tough to understand for a non-IT since they use the Java basics and all.
Not it's very easy. Initially, that's what I told. 2 to 3 days, you will not be very comfortable because you are not used to those keywords. You will not be used to those programming plugins, but after 3-4 days and based on your practice, you will be easily able to grasp it. It's very basic Java as well as advanced level also. We will go ahead for Selenium what all topics we need I'll be covering, but I'm sure I have trained just a few days back.
Okay.
I completed a batch and there were people. Not an issue.
I have one last question.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I have one last question. Like regarding the when you have the choice of the advanced EFT and the Selenium testing, so which one should be your opt? Like many people will be telling the Selenium is also in boom, and then since we get to know the knowledge of basic EFT in our QA course, so. Some people tell that if you go for advanced UFT, you will get more knowledge in depth. So which one do you think
I'll ask you this question. Something which you are getting for free, let's say you are getting, let's say there's an apple, okay? You're getting the same apple. UFT is also used for functional testing. Selenium is also used for functional testing, right? and you have an Apple, so something mm-hmm. which is available for free, you will buy that free Apple, or you will pay some $220 for an Apple and buy that. Mm-hmm. Which one will you buy? The one which is free. Yeah, Selenium, yeah. Of course, the one we have to choose. And the reason also, many companies are also going for Selenium, startups and people, you know, they don't want to invest money in buying a license for UFT, you know. And mm-hmm. even if they buy the license, they will get only one or two licenses. Only one or two testers or one or two machines you can use for your testing. But if you have Selenium, 10 testers can test it, or on 10 different machines, you can test different test cases at the same time. That you cannot do using UFT. Okay. Mm-hmm. So you're using UFT, it will be restricted functional testing. But with Selenium, you can go all ahead and do your testing okay. in different browsers. That's not supported by UFT. So your testing will be on the whole holistic testing view. You will get it using Selenium.
Okay. Thank
and
you.
The language that you're using in UFT is, I think, DB+, which is really not very easy to learn. Scripting also is a little bit tough in UFT, but in Selenium it's very easy. Java is an easy language.
Yeah, what we learned in UFT and in LoadRunner was basic kind, like not really writing the script, a little bit enhancing and all that we did. So that we learned actually. Mm-hmm.
But that tool itself has the enhancing options, right? It gives you mm-hmm. runtime settings, all that.
Yeah.
In Selenium, you will do as part of scripting. You'll write the code for that.
Okay.